Good evening. Welcome to Trinity Saturday Evening Worship Service. If you could, please take a moment to fill out one of the blue cards that can be found in the pew back in front of you. You can also fill out an online attendance form by scanning the QR code that's on the card in the pew back in front of you. This is how Trinity keeps our membership list up to date, and we would love to drop you a quick note if this is your first time here. If you're interested in giving to Trinity using your cell phone, you can scan the QR code in the bulletin or text to 407-809-1560 to get started. If you are in need of prayer, an elder will be available at the front right of the sanctuary after the service to pray with you, and that's the little side chapel right over here. The next Fellowship of Christian Athletes Trinity Youth Ministry event will be held this weekend. It's tomorrow, Sunday, April 7th. We hope to see you there. Trinity will be hosting a volunteer appreciation lunch after church on Sunday, April 14th. The deadline for volunteers to sign up to attend this event is this weekend. If you actively serve at Trinity, we invite you to the event. A sign-up sheet can be found in the Narthex or in the Weekly. And you can get a hold of Darlene Sabin if you have any questions. The next Family Fun Night event will be held on Friday, April 19th at 6:30 p.m. We hope you will join us for a fun evening of food and fellowship. Our next voters meeting will be held on Sunday, April 21st, immediately after the 11:15 a.m. service or 12:30 p.m. Please plan to stay and take part in this meeting. We hope to have some additional details on the associate pastor call process, which we can get to you during that meeting. And also, just wanted to mention, and if I may be stealing some thunder from Pastor, but we did very well with attendance last weekend. Across the four services, we had almost 400 people attend. So it was somewhere around 385, 386. I don't remember exactly which it was. So thanks to all of you for being so welcoming to the visitors that we did have. Pastor?
Good evening, everyone.
Testing. Okay. Well, I want to say Pastor Eduardo is not going to be with us this weekend, nor will he be at Esperanza Viva. And so our prayers and thoughts are going to be with him. He's getting better. We're trying to make sure he does. But I also would like to say greetings to each one of you. And if you would be so kind as to stand and to welcome one another with a handshake of warmth and welcome, that would be wonderful.
Each of you here this evening to Trinity, and we make our beginning in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Beloved in the Lord, let us draw near with a true heart and confess our sins unto God, our Father, beseeching him in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to grant us forgiveness. Our help is in the name of the Lord. I said I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord. We pause in silence. O Lord, hearing the confession of our sins, O Almighty God, merciful Father, I, a poor, miserable sinner, confess unto you all my sins and iniquities, with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserve your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent of them, and I pray you for the mercy of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor, sinful being. Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office, as a called and ordained servant of the Lord, and at the command of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Everything that has breath, everything that has breath, praise Him. Everything that has breath, praise He the Lord. Everything that has breath, everything that has breath, praise Him. Everything that has breath, praise He the Lord.
Let everything that has breath now praise Him. If He's been good to you, then why not lift your voice to praise Him? He's been good to me, I'm going to praise Him. To lift my voice up to the sky and praise Him. We sing,
everything that has breath, everything that has breath, praise Him. Everything that has breath, praise He the Lord. Everything that has breath, everything that has breath, praise Him. Everything that has breath, praise He the Lord.
Let us pray together. Almighty God, grant that we who have celebrated the Lord's resurrection may by your grace confess in our life and conversation that Jesus, Lord and God, through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
First reading is from the book of Acts, chapter 4, beginning with verse 32. The full number of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one said that any of the things that belonged to him was his own, but they had everything in common. And with great power, the apostles were giving their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as were owners of lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold and laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. This is the word of the Lord. Tonight's epistle is from 1 John chapter 1, beginning with verse 1. That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon and have touched with our hands concerning the word of life, the life was made manifest, and we have seen it, and testified to it, and proclaimed to you the eternal life, which was with the Father, and was made manifest to us. That which we have seen and heard, we proclaim also to you, so that you too may have fellowship. And indeed, our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. And we are writing these things so that our joy may be complete. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaimed to you, that God is light and in him is no darkness at all. If we say we have fellowship with him while we walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. This is the word of the Lord.
To have the voices
Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 20th chapter. On the evening of the day, that first day of the week, the doors being locked, where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came among them, and he said to them, "Peace be with you." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples were glad, and when they saw the Lord, Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so now I am sending you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and he said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of anyone, they are forgiven. If you withhold the sins from anyone, they are withheld." Now Thomas was not with them on that evening. He was called the twin. And so the other disciples told him, "We've seen the Lord." And Thomas said, "Unless I see in his hands the marks of the nail and place my finger into the marks and my hand into his side, I will not believe." 8 days later, his disciples were inside again, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood amongst them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put here your finger and see my hands, and put out your hand and place it into my side. Do not disbelieve, but rather believe." Thomas answered Jesus, "My Lord and my God." And Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of the disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing in him, you may have life in his name. This is the gospel of our Lord. We now confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated.
To the three, your
Grace, mercy, and peace be richly and abundantly poured out upon each of you. Our text is the gospel lesson for today, John 20, 19 to 31. I invite you to follow along as we turn to that. There's a pew Bible in front of you, or your cell phones, or any other means you might have that you would like to look that up and follow along. I begin this message by asking you, what fears do you have? What locked doors are you hiding behind? The disciples, as we read in this text, were locked behind those doors because they feared for their very lives. They may have been with Jesus. They may have heard his message, seen his miracles, but Christ had been crucified in a horrendous, cruel, terrible way, killed on a cross, and they had been eyewitnesses to it. They had seen what happened, and now they went into hiding. They thought that since Jesus had been crucified and his body was now missing, as reported by the women who had gone to the tomb, that the authorities would certainly be coming and looking for them, knocking on their doors. How will they be able to escape? Perhaps you've got things that you're fearful of. I must admit that I'm fearful of an upcoming surgery to an extent. How will I live life, be non-weight-bearing for multiple weeks? How much pain will I have to endure, be in, and for how long? When we look at all of those things in our lives, we too can be fearful. I know that many of you are facing real life issues. Your health is waning. You feel weak, perhaps alone, helpless, unable to help yourself. You fear what lies ahead, what the future holds, you know, the unknown. And in your mind, you imagine the worst. Others have lost loved ones and have that empty feeling inside of their heart, at their dinner table, inside of their home. Your heart aches for them as well. You miss them oh so much. Still others are facing or fearing going back to work or to school because of something that happened. It seems so huge now. We all have fears, don't we? But what do we do with them? How do we handle them? The Bible tells us to let us fix our eyes upon Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. How did help Jesus, however, help calm the fears of his disciples? Quite simply, he shows up. That's what our text tells us tonight, that Jesus shows up in the situation they found themselves in. Behind locked doors, hiding for fear of their very life, knowing the authorities were coming and coming for them. And it likely wasn't going to end well. We read it on the day of the evening of that first day, the first day of the week, you know, Easter Sunday, the doors being locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and he stood amongst them. And he said to them, "Peace be with you." Jesus appears behind locked doors, and he's alive. He's feared. This fear that they had, they were facing a man that was now alive that they thought to be dead. Look what he did. He showed them that he was alive. And as you and I start to face up to our fears and our frustrations and our concerns, we see that the Lord has been with us also, that he shows up in many of the times of our life that we've gone through similar things or other things that could be related to that. And we see how he helped get us through. But the disciples on this evening, when they knew death was so imminent, not only for Jesus, that he'd already died, but they thought they too were going to. Death had not defeated him. The cross had not conquered him. The cross had not conquered or crushed him, and death had not defeated him. Jesus had overcome the power of death and the grave. The very things they feared, Christ had overcome. And that's how they began to face their fear, is because Jesus showed up. As you and I think of our lives, have you seen times where Jesus showed up? I must admit that I have. I must admit that the fears had started to become a bit overwhelming for me, even consuming the closer I get to this surgery date. So I invited Jesus to show up. I spent more time in his word. I invite you to do the same. I spent more time listening and praying. I listened for what it said to me. And I prayed for his help, his coming, as well as his calming. I recalled that in my past prayers that I've said over years and times of other troubling times, how Jesus had pulled me through. I went back to journaling, writing down my very thoughts as they were appearing in my mind, feelings that included my fears and frustrations. And I turned those over to Jesus, and he showed up. And he showed up calming me and calming my fears. We also resumed our prayer Bible study, the weekly prayer Bible study that we have. And I was so thankful for that because we had taken a hiatus during Lent. It gave us strength, and it gave me strength. Friends, listen to Christ's words, "Peace be with you." The Greek word is eirene. It means, and it describes, a peace that is so powerful that it penetrates the deepest of darknesses. It pierces through and crushes all that we fear, including death. It dispels darkness, doubt, horrors, and hopelessness, giving us a peace that surpasses all human understanding. It really, really does. Jesus is alive. Death did not defeat him, not even death on a cross. And now Jesus gives to them, these disciples, his peace, this powerful peace. There was once a man in our congregation who'd learned of a grave illness that he was going to be going through. He just found out, along with his family. I remember that day where we went to talk with him. It was a terrible day. Sadness filled his heart. But as we spoke to him about a hope that gets past the sickness and the coming death. And we turned that day from sadness to a day of some celebration as he and I began to plan his memorial service along with his family. And we saw that horror turn into some hope. And we saw that which was feared to become that of faith and a trust in Jesus Christ himself. Friends, Jesus said to him, as he said to the family, and as he said to me, as he says to you right now, "Peace be with you." Next, Jesus shows the disciples his hands and his side, and he says, "It's me, I'm alive." Or to quote Pastor Zender, "Ta-da!" It's an inside joke. I'll tell you later, okay? But I want you to know that Jesus shows himself to be alive. Somehow their fears begin to fade, and the Lord would empower them. The very ones who feared would now become the ones who would go to tell the world. The ones who were locked behind doors of doubt and despair and fear and frustration were now going to be the ones who would go outside the doors to tell the entire world. That was going to be the mission Jesus would leave for them. And the text says the disciples were glad to see the Lord. And Jesus says to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so now I am sending you." And when he did that, he breathes on them the Holy Spirit. And he tells them, if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. But if you retain the sins of any, they are retained and withheld. As the Father sends Jesus, he now sends you, and he now sends me as his fellow believers. To share this wondrous good news, the disciples were tasked with evangelizing the entire world and going and making disciples of all people, baptizing and teaching them all things whatsoever Christ has commanded. As Christians and as a member of Trinity Lutheran Church, in our baptism, we have come to Christ, a living stone. We are a chosen people, a royal priesthood. We are being built up as a spiritual house, able to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable unto God through Jesus. God has declared you and me to be priests and priestesses. Our membership has meaning. When we proclaim the word of God, it has power and authority, forgiving even sins. And the Holy Spirit goes to work to create and sustain faith. You and I are a part of God's plan to reach people for salvation for eternity. Christ not only sent them, the disciples, he also sends us. As he breathes on us the Holy Spirit at our baptisms, at Holy Communion, as we hear the Word of God, as he answers prayers, and as he comes into our world and into our lives. God works and is working through what you and I say to tell others about Jesus. Christ, who overcame death and the grave, speaks to you and to me, saying, "Peace I give you. I am sending you as the Father has sent me, and he's sending you and me in Christ's name to proclaim this repentance and forgiveness of sins." Can you imagine how powerful that is? Husbands and wives who've gotten into fights and arguments. Sons and daughters, parents and sons and daughters. Neighbors against neighbors, co-workers against co-workers. Being able to look him or her in the eye and saying, "In the name of Jesus, I forgive you. In the name of Jesus, repent. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus," that's what you and I get to do. Now, Thomas, you remember, was not with the disciples when Jesus had come that first time. But he said, "Unless I see the prints in his hands and place my fingers into them and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." You and I have met those Thomases, haven't we? "Unless God does this, I won't do that." I want you to know, I've met a lot of them. But I've seen God have his way with them. And how God, in his mercy and grace, reaches out to them, touches them, and draws them in closer and closer and closer. Loving on them, caring for them, hearing and answering their prayers, and God causes all things to work together for good and to bring them closer to him. And for them to come to that point where Thomas was, or kneeling at the feet of Jesus, he confesses and says, "My Lord and my God, it is you. You are alive. You really are." At the end of this chapter, in this text, it says, "Now Jesus did many other things in the presence of the disciples, which were not written. But these are written so that you and me, may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing in his name, you have life, life everlasting, eternal life." I want you to hear another part of 1 John. "That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our own eyes." This is one of Jesus' disciples. We've seen Jesus with our own eyes, which we have looked at and we've touched with our own hands. Concerning the word of life, this is the resurrected Christ he's speaking of. This life was made manifest, shown to us, and we have seen it. And we testify to it and we proclaim it to you, this eternal life. That which we have seen and that which we have heard, we proclaim to you so that you may have fellowship with us. Be a fellow believer. And so that you may have the joy we have in knowing that Jesus has forgiven us of our sins. In Jesus' name. May you and I be a part of bringing that joy full circle to many other people in the blessed name of Jesus. Amen.
You would be mindful of us. What do you see that's worth looking our way? We are free in ways that we never should be. Sweet release from the grip of these chains. Like hinges straining from the weight, my heart no longer can keep from singing. All that is within me cries for you alone. Be glorified, Emmanuel. God with us. My heart sings a brand new song. The debt is paid, these chains are gone. Emmanuel, God with us. Lord, you know our hearts don't deserve your glory. Still you show love we cannot afford. Like hinges straining from the weight, my heart no longer can keep from singing. All that is within me cries for you alone. Be glorified, Emmanuel, God with us. My heart sings a brand new song. The debt is paid, these chains are gone. Emmanuel, God with us. Such a tiny offering compared to Calvary. Nevertheless, we lay it at your feet. such a tiny offering compared to Calvary. Nevertheless, we lay this at your feet. All that is within me cries, for you alone be glorified, Emmanuel, God with us. My heart sings a brand new song. My debt is paid, these chains are gone, Emmanuel, God with us.
Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us. And now, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us.
Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is truly meet, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, and most especially are we bound to praise you on this day for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, the very Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and bore the sins of the entire world. By his dying, he has destroyed death, and by his rising again, he has restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with Mary Magdalene, Peter and John, and with all the witnesses of the resurrection, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and we magnify thy glorious name, and praising you, singing.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy, and earth are full of
heaven and earth are full of
full of your power and glory,
full of your power and glory.
Blessed are all who come in the name of the Lord.
Blessed are all who come in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
together. Hosanna! Hosanna in the highest!
We come before your throne of mercy and of grace. We give you thanks that you appeared to the disciples to calm their fears, to show yourself alive, to show them that through your resurrection, the price had been paid for sins of the entire world, including theirs. The fears which they possessed were overcome, as well as death and the grave, sin and damnation. Lord, you calm our fears as well, and when you show up in our life and world, we ask that you would be with those who are undergoing surgeries, such as Alan Kimmel, such as Sheila Matthews. Also, we pray for those who are undergoing continued recovery from ailments and sickness. We pray that you would be with our pastor or our brother Eduardo. May you bring help and healing to his body from this sickness and suffering. In Jesus' name, we place each and every one of them. We also pray, Lord, for the call process, for our call committee, and for our congregation. Lord, may your will be done, and may you lead us to the candidate of your choice. May you show us that person and enable them and empower them and send them to serve you here in this ministry with us. And may we readily receive them and welcome them as your servant in Jesus' name. I pray also for the leadership of this congregation and for the many blessings that they are to myself, my family, and each of the ministries we do together. May you bless Trinity Lutheran Church and school in Jesus' name. We now pray that prayer which you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day your daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had broken it, he gave thanks and he gave it unto his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body given unto death for you. Do this. Likewise, he also took the cup, and after he had supped, he gave thanks, and he gave it unto his disciples, saying, take and drink ye all of it, for this cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is given and is shed for you for the remission of all your sins. As often as you drink it, do so in remembrance of me. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
How can it be the one who died has borne our sin through sacrifice to conquer every sting of death? Sing, sing hallelujah. For joy awakes as dawning light when Christ's disciples lift their eyes. Alive he stands, their friend and king. Christ, Christ, he is risen. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. Oh, sing hallelujah. Join the chorus, sing with the redeemed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. Where doubt and darkness once had been, they saw him and their hearts believed. But blessed are those who have not seen yet. Sing hallelujah. Once bound by fear, now bold in faith, they preach the truth and power of grace. And pouring out their lives, they gained life, life everlasting. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. Oh, sing hallelujah. Join the chorus, sing with the redeemed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. The power that raised him from the grave now works in us to powerfully save. He frees our hearts to live his grace. God love his goodness. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. Oh, sing hallelujah. Join the chorus, sing with the redeemed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. Oh, sing hallelujah. Join the chorus, sing with the redeemed. Christ is risen, he is risen indeed. He's alive, he's alive. Heaven's gates are open wide. He's alive, he's alive. Now in heaven glorified. He's alive, he's alive. Heaven's gates are open wide. He's alive, he's alive. Now in heaven glorified, he's alive, he's alive. Heaven's gates are open wide, he's alive, he's alive. Now in heaven glorified.
And now may this body and blood of our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and preserve in you in his body and in his blood to strengthen you, calm your fears, and to be with you in every day and every way until life everlasting. Depart in his peace. Amen. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and to be gracious unto you, to lift upon you with his favor and grant you his peace.
Thank you.
As Jesus said to his disciples, I now say, using his words, as the Father sent me, so now I am sending you. Go and serve him gladly. In the name of Jesus, amen.